really like this question. And it's clear that you've thought about it a lot, which makes it even more fun for me to discuss. And it is a really good question for analysis of a bunch of different topics. So let's look at it from top down. So the first one is going to be a really boring explanation, but the first thing is legal liability. So in your case of Listerine solution, it's going to be a little bit overdramatic. So let me take a little bit of a simpler one. Let's talk about Lysol. So Lysol is this giant brand where millions and millions of people buy their products and use it every day, and they use it to clean surfaces. Now, if you market it as 100% of germs, and there's even one germ that remains, now you're liable to being sued. 99.9% is a nice marketing way of saying it kills basically all germs, but we can't be responsible if there's no germs done. Now, that doesn't mean that they're this evil corporation that's lying to you. This is also biologically the case. So the second thing is biology. Now, I like that you were able to distinguish between pathogens and germs. I can assure you that the research development team that work on Listerine, Lysol, Windex, whatever you want to call it, all these companies that are working on disinfectants, they have extensive biology, chemistry, physics, research development teams that know exactly what they're talking about, exactly what pathogens they're targeting, why their solution targets those pathogens. But the reason that they can't say it's going to kill 100% of those pathogens is because of something called mutation. So mutation is the, very simply speaking, is the ability for, is not the ability, is the fact that as a cell reproduces, its genetic material is subject to change. So in some cases, that subject to change is very small, especially in the cases of, it's difficult to quantify like that. But in some cases, the mutation could be something completely innocuous, like you don't recognize it at all, or it could completely change every single thing. Every aspect you look at in a human being, in an animal, in a plant, all of those things are the result of a mutation. The fact that my hair is black and my friend's hair is blonde, that is a form of a mutation in and of itself. Now, mutation has a very negative connotation thanks to media and thanks to, you know, the word itself sounds a little bit scary, but a mutation just means a change in the DNA. Now, when we're looking at germs, germs have very, very, very short lifestyles and very, very, very fast reproductive cycles, right? Let's say that a germ duplicates every 2 hours. So if we're starting with 100 germs or pathogens, but let's just say germs because it's more encompassing. If we're talking about a 100 germs that you're starting with, in 2 hours you have 200, in 4 hours you have 400, in 8 hours, in 6 hours you have 800. And it doesn't seem like that much, but it's going to be going at an exponentially quicker rate, right? So there's no point in doing the math, but within a day you're going to have millions and millions and millions of pathogens, which means, or germs, which means that you're going to have millions and millions and millions of opportunities for a mutation. So the proteins or the enzymes or the active ingredient, to make it very simple, that is in these antiseptic solutions are going to be targeting a specific protein of the germ. But now, if that germ is exposed to that antiseptic, whether it's exposed to it or not, by just pure freak chance, which is the very definition of evolution, which is the very, not definition, but the very basis of evolution, just the fact that certain species evolved to have these mutations that somehow luckily made them able to just survive better than the other organisms in their species. That is how evolution happens, and that's exactly what's happening with germs. Because it's happening so much quicker, you can't say that 100% are going to be wiped out. Because if even one germ develops the mutation that allows it to survive against this specific protein. So let's say protein A in the antiseptic is going to be targeting protein 1 in the germ. If even one germ gets protein 2, protein A is no longer going to be effective on protein 2. So now you're going to have an entire population of protein 2. So you can't say that. It's obviously much, much more complicated than this, but because of mutations, because they reproduce so quickly, it's impossible to completely eliminate every single germ. And is it a marketing fraud? No, I think 99.9% is more of just a nice big number that they can say is pretty much everything while keeping their own legal team safe and being honest, because it's impossible. It is physically impossible to guarantee anything is 100% in science.